Welcome, everybody, to beautiful Miami and Hard Rock Stadium, site of this year's Capital One Orange Bowl, part, of course, of the college football playoff. We are through the opening round of this year's playoff, and now the pressure is mounting in the quarterfinals, a matchup between one side that's had time to rest and recover and another team that's battle-tested, already off one playoff victory. As we'll see, the number 8 seed in this playoff, the Arkansas Razorbacks, taking on the top-seeded team in the playoff, the Alabama Crimson Tide. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, here in the booth with Kirk Herbstreit. And here we go, a college football playoff quarterfinal game. Only one team here can keep their championship dreams alive. Team is out there. Great energy as this playoff game is about to get underway. Bringing it out, it's Johnson. To be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? QB decides to keep it here. He gains 9, so it's 2nd and 1.
Chris, I know it's the first play of the game, but boy, nice job by this offensive line. The back gets behind him, picks up some positive yards.
Here's the handoff. Moves the ball out across the 30, and it's good for a first down.
Boy, the speed of this back is impressive today for Arkansas, and they've had some big-time backs that have played in Fayetteville. Darren McFadden, one of my favorite players that I ever saw play in the SEC. Felix Jones with speed on the outside, and today this guy's showing what he can do.
First down and 10 now. Looking to pass. It's Green. Looking right. This one caught. They stop him, but it's a first down.
Nice read here by the Arkansas quarterback to be able to make this throw and pick up a first down for the Hogs. Did a nice job of waiting for his receiver to get open and then put the ball right on the money.
The Razorbacks will have 1st and 10 here. It's a draw play. And that's a solid gain for the defense, able to bring it down.
Great job by the offensive line here, opening up some holes and giving the running back room to run on first down. Plays like this can open up the playbook for the play caller, allow him to make that defense think, are they going to run? Maybe play action, maybe throw the ball downfield.
Quarterback looking to pass here on 2nd down. That's reeled in. It's Hill. Defense surrounds it. Just a short gain on that completion.
Hey, they get some positive yards here. But just from sitting up here looking down, Chris, you kind of have a sense that they wanted a little bit more on that play.
Crucial 3rd down play coming up. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. And they hit him just as he releases the ball. It's incomplete.
How about the call here? They go with the screen on 3rd down and short. You don't see that call very often. They're not able to even complete the pass, so no chance at a conversion. So we got 4th and short.
And at 4th down, they'll punt it away here. And the returner decides to signal fair catch.
Mm-hmm.
offense. Quarterback pulls the ball. It's a keeper. Hits some space around the 30. Moves the ball out across the 30, and that's good for a first down.
Boy, this offense does such a great job of putting the threat of the quarterback and the running back on this defense. It puts the defense in a tough spot because it's really hard to take both away. This time, the quarterback gets out and shows you the speed he has as well.
Fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. And now the handoff. They bring him down, but a big chunk of yardage on the play.
There's nothing more that helps an offense than committing to that running game and popping an explosive run like this on the ground. Keeps the confidence of your offensive lineup. Same with your back. It helps everything else that you're doing as an offense in your rhythm. Now you can come back with some counters, try to take some shots off of play action, and keep hammering away with that run game.
On first and 10, looking to throw. Makes a quick grab. And the broken tackle there produces a solid gain.
Well, this is why they want to get his hands on the football as often as possible. We always know about his ability to make plays downfield, but here they just get it to him quick on a wide receiver screen. He shakes the tackle and picks up nice yards.
The completion makes it second down. The offense will now quickly spend a timeout.
Timeout, Alabama.
Second down after that previous play. Looks right for a quick completion. In the clear at the 25. Takes it all the way to the house. Touchdown, tied.
That kind of play is almost impossible to defend. When the quarterback is throwing the ball with that kind of accuracy and timing, and the receiver runs a route like this, good luck trying to stop it. So maybe this is a great start for this combination, this quarterback and receiver, for a big day.
PAT is good, so it's 7-0. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. Fielded in the end zone. It's Anthony. Solid coverage there. They get him at the 50.
At the 15.
This will take over. Back out on the field now. They were forced to punt last time. Can they get this offense going finally? Get some points out of this possession. Buying time now, rolling to his left. Makes the catch. It's Haas. And heads out of bounds after a decent game.
Nice play action.
And the replay booth has signaled they want to stop and have another look at this one. Well, they took a look just to confirm it, but it looks like they got it right on the field. After the review, the play will stand. Getting set. Here's second down. Scanning the field. It's Green. Quick throw to the left side. And he's got it. Breaks clear. End zone ahead. And a huge gain before he's forced out of bounds. big yardage to set up a fresh set of downs.
Boy, huge play by this offense. A good throw, a nice, accurate throw. But I think it's the run after the catch that really impresses me. And early in this game, you got to think they're going to continue to go back to him until this defense shows that they can slow him down.
Minimal gain brought down short of the marker.
You know, in the era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example. The defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage and not give up big run plays.
Catch made over the middle. They've got him, but that completion good enough for first down yardage.
Well, it's so easy to get caught up in the receivers and the quarterback, and your eyes get lost and forget about the running back. Nice catch and a first down for this offense.
And they'll run it out of the shotgun.
I tell you, to be able to pick up a nice gain like that, those offensive linemen have to sustain their blocks. Gave them a chance at a really nice gain.
And the Razorbacks looking to take advantage of this red zone trip. Looking to pass here on second down. On the run here, lets it go. And the pass is complete to the tight end. Tackled at the 6-yard line after the completion. Offense really threatening now. The Razorbacks will line up now. It's first and goal. Keep it on the ground on first and goal. Oh, they've got it behind the line. A tackle for loss to conclude the first quarter of play. Crucial play here to begin the quarter as the offense sets up with a second and goal. And the senior able to make the stop after a short gain.
Hey, the defense is doing everything that they can to try to keep these guys out of the end zone. Now we've got a big third down coming up.
Great job by the defense so far. It's third and goal from a long way out. Dropping back, it's Green. Breaks free. And the defense closes in quickly to stop him short of the goal line.
Oh my gosh, Chris. I thought he was going to be able to find a way to get to the end zone. He is such a threat when he takes off. He pulls that ball down and tries to get to the end zone on these scrambles. But the defense just keeps him out of the goal line.
It's QB sneak. And he gets to the end zone. Touchdown, Hawks. And they'll set up for the PAT. And there's the point after. Now they get set to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. The offense will start at the 25. Here comes the Alabama offense onto the field. They punched it in the last possession. Can they do it again, or will this defense make some adjustments to get a stop? Off the play fake, looking to throw. On the run here, lets it go. Grab near the sticks. It's Hale. Powering through the defender. They bring him down, but that is a huge play for this passing game. Big game.
Chris, all week they heard about how fast this guy is. The defensive coordinator told them. They watched the film. They've seen this guy a lot. But I think the reality of seeing it now in person, I think it surprised them. They've got to make some adjustments to their defense, or this guy and his speed will continue to have a field day.
Hand off to the back. Defense makes the stop after a 5-yard gain, so second and 5.
It's a good, solid game. 5 or 6 yards? Love to see that from the running game.
Important second down play coming up. The offense will call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
Timeout, Alabama.
Second down play coming up for this offense. Moving the receiver around pre-snap. A pop pass on the jet sweep. Inside the 25. Tackled, but forced down.
The defense has got to do a much better job here of adjusting to the pre-snap motion. They just kind of stayed in place, and it gave the receiver plenty of room there to make a nice play.
Pre-snap motion from the receiver. Trying to flex the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. And they don't block the defensive end and show some quickness, Kirk, getting around the edge that time.
Yeah, this guy's usually getting around the edge to put pressure on the quarterback, but he reminds everybody here that this guy's a complete package. Not only can he pressure the quarterback, but also he is very, very talented and shows you the physicality he has against the run as well.
Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. They tackle him. Looks like it's going to be just short of the mark, inches away.
Well, heck, if they hadn't dug themselves such a big hole, what a positive play here. Using that jet motion and that touch pass to pick up some huge yards and giving them a chance anyway of trying to come up with a first down.
This is crucial. Defense needing a stop on third down, trying to force a field goal. Third down, it's a handoff. Tackled at the 5-yard line. Now it's first and goal right there.
Yeah, I love how the back didn't really dance around trying to make a big play. He knew it was third down in inches, lower the shoulder, get the first down.
The Tide offense line up here on first and goal.
29 Philly. 2-9 Philly.
And now they'll run it on the draw. Tackle behind the line. It's a loss of two.
And it's first and goal. You're thinking about trying to score. You're looking at positive yards instead. You're going backwards. That's going to set up a very important second down call here.
So off the loss, it's second and goal from the 8. That's the 2-minute warning now here in the first half. Using his legs, it's Miller. He's swarmed by the defense.
Well, Chris, we're still here in the first half, but you got to wonder after that stop there on third down, now we got a fourth down situation. And now you're in the red zone. I wonder, you want to take the 3 points the easy way, or do you roll the dice, try to take a chance, try to come up with a touchdown?
And now the defense decides to spend a timeout to regroup a bit. Out comes the field goal unit. So it'll be a chip shot from the right hash mark. kick is good. He knocked it right down the middle.
And that one, my gosh, I mean, it's almost too easy. Nice kick.
They come away with 3 points on the drive, and now the kickoff team will boot it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so a touchback will start the 25. And the Razorbacks' offense is back out on the field. If they want to cut into this lead before halftime, they have to work quickly now. And a sophomore making an impact play.
Well, you got to do a better job with your fake as a quarterback. The defense did not bite at all on the play action, allowing them to continue to come after the quarterback and come up with that sack.
This big guy's up front will have to regroup now. It's second and 14. Dropping back, it's Green. Catch made down the left side, an explosive play. Timeout is called to talk strategy late in this close game with halftime approaching.
Chris, that's another positive game for this offense, and this quarterback continues to show why he's had such a great year this year. When he has time to throw, he gets his feet set. He's as accurate as any quarterback in the country.
On first and 10, they'll look to throw it. He's on the run. Launches deep. Oh, and he's got it. Big gain inside the 25. They bring him down, but an explosive play by this offense. Big gain. Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. And he's tackled, but only after picking up a first down. And the Razorbacks will crank up the tempo. First down, looking to throw the football. Makes the grab, can he get there? Brought down at the 3 after the completion. The offense really threatening now. They'll crank up the tempo here on second down. The time is running out. Out of the shotgun, he hands it off. Defense able to stop the ball carrier there. They get to the line in a hurry here for this third down. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. That one is incomplete. The defender was right there, and it brings up fourth down now.
Hey, the good news is here, Chris, they're still in field goal range, and they didn't cost themselves any points. But they could have more. You've got to be thinking about going for this on fourth and short.
The decision is not to go for it on fourth down. Here comes the field goal team. They'll set up at the right hash mark for this chip shot. And the defense will call timeout here with the age-old practice of trying to ice the kicker. So the coach will decide to settle for 3 points here. Out comes the field goal unit. So it'll be a chip shot from the right hash mark. And he knocks it right through the uprights. That will tie things up as we head toward halftime. So they settle for 3 here, and now the kickoff. See if the opposing offense can answer before halftime. And it's fielded. Returner trying to make something happen. And he's tackled at the 21. That's where the drive will start. Offense takes the field in the final seconds of the half. Chance for just a couple more plays. Ball handed off. Breaking free at the 35. And bulldozing his way through. And the defense tackles him in what should be the final play of this first half.
number zero on the field goal.
Miller's going to wrap up the first half here. Let's kick it now to Kevin Connors with our halftime update. The Razorbacks will kick this away to get the second half going. Well, he thought about coming out, but instead takes a knee to bring the football to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Crimson Tide offense onto the field. And they'll start the third quarter here on the ground. That's a nice tackle there by the senior. Offense getting set. Second down play here. Receivers now getting some new assignments before the snap. And they're moving the receiver now before the snap. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Running with purpose. They tackle him right at the 35-yard line.
You know, the good thing about this play is it's not an explosive play, but it really gives you a chance now to be able to pick up a first down here on this next play.
It's third down for the offense. They'll try to move the chains here on the ground. Breaking free at midfield. Tackled across midfield at the 48. Good enough for a first down. Alabama comes up to the line quickly. And they'll go right back to him on first down. Defense stops him, but that's a solid gain. The gain makes it second and medium.
Well, much like what we saw in the first half, Chris, in this playoff game, no adjustments. Go right back to giving this running back the football. He's had a monster day and continues to get positive yards.
And the ball is handed off out of the shotgun. And a decent gain there before the defense brings him down.
Well, I know this defense worked very hard at halftime to come up with answers on how to try to slow down this running back after the big first half, and he's already at it again.
Solid gain in the running play. Third down now. The pre-snap motion from the offense. A pop pass on the jet sweep. And moves the ball to the 35 and another first down.
Yeah, to me, Chris, with this offense, it's almost an extension of their running game. You put the receiver out in motion. You flip the ball out to him, out to the outside. Let him do what he does best, which is use his instincts. And he picks up a first down.
This Alabama offense is moving quickly down the field.
Come on, set. Flip it.
On the run, it's Miller.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
Offense lines up. This is the seventh play now on this drive.
Easy.
Receiver in motion now. Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
Well, that's exactly what defensive coordinators love to see. You've got a quarterback that typically is known for his ability to cover, and here he shows some physical toughness by sticking his nose in there, and he comes up with a nice play and support.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. On the shotgun, it's a handoff. And they pick up the first down, tackled at the 25.
Look, I realize on any play call, when it's properly executed, it can go to the house for a touchdown. But the runs that really make a game plan work are the ones where you get just what you need. And he barely got the first down, but he got it.
Alabama getting set with a first and 10 coming up. Quarterback appears to be changing the play. And then first down, right back to the running game. March continues. Offense pushing the ball down the field. They'll run it here. Running back has the ball. Got space looking for the end zone here. Touchdown, Alabama. That puts them on top in the second half. That kind of execution, the long drive, that's why this team made it to the college football playoff.
That's exactly right. Being able to mix in the run with the pass, picking up first downs, and eventually coming up with the touchdown. That is a tough thing to do, and they made it look easy.
Kickoff team is on the field. Let's see if they give the returner a chance to bring this one back. Bringing it out, it's Anthony. They tackle him at the 9. That's good coverage. They should have left the ball in the end zone. Arkansas offense back out on the field. The last possession, they had to settle for a chip shot field goal. Can they find the end zone this time out? The shotgun handoff here. He stopped, but he gets a first down.
Chris, the thing that I love about this play is the running back showing great patience and then the vision to find that hole and then accelerate through it for a nice gain.
This offense is rolling at the moment. It's first down and 10. Looking to throw. It's Green. And he finds the running back in the flat. They bring him down after a short gain there.
One thing I love about this back is how he gets involved in the passing game. Nice catch here.
The completion sets up a second down play. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Moves the ball up to the 30.
Well, I feel like they called that knowing chances are they're not going to hit a home run, but look at this. Put themselves in a perfect third down situation. It's much more manageable. Now we'll see if they can convert.
So ball at the 30. This is a manageable third down play for the offense. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. Scrambling, now he'll make the throw. It's caught downfield. That's a big gain before he goes out of bounds. It'll move the sticks, more than enough for a first down.
Boy, nice throw here by this Arkansas quarterback to be able to pick up big yards and a first down for the Hogs. And Chris, they've had some great ones over the years that could distribute to football. Ryan Mallett, Tyler Wilson, Clint Sterner, just to name a few.
Runner finding some space there. That's a solid gain on the ground.
Man, you know, the back gets a lot of the attention here. He's a good back. I love to see that offensive line win the battle of the line of scrimmage.
Offense coming to the line. They might have a chance for a couple more plays before we reach the end of the quarter. Second down, we're going to throw it. He's moving out of the pocket. The throw complete to the running back underneath. And the tackle is made in what's going to be the final play of this period. Back at it to start the quarter. Offense getting set to run a first down play. Here we go. Brought down after picking up 5 yards, so second and 5.
It's a really good, solid run. I know it's not the flashiest big play, but it's important for your offense to be able to get yards like that on early down to stay ahead of the chains, and it opens up the playbook for the second and third down coming up.
To throw, it's Green. Quarterback finds an open target on the left side. And he'll get the first down yards before they finally bring him down.
Defense kind of lost the running back here. Makes a nice catch and gets the first down in the process.
Running back with the football. Only a small gain. Now looking at second and nine. Here's the snap. Offense looking to throw the ball. Makes the catch. Can he get in? And he will score. Touchdown, Arkansas.
Man, I love running backs that can hurt you on the ground and through the air. The defense this time just underestimates his ability to catch the ball and then the speed afterwards. It's a touchdown.
And the important PAT is up and good. We're tied in the fourth. Kick bounces out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Alabama's offense coming back onto the field. The last drive, the ground game was so successful. Ended in a touchdown. We'll see if the defense can respond to it this time. They're going to run it here.
Well, the defense coordinator this week all week telling us about gap integrity, not giving this running back any creases at all. Really sound defense on that play.
Now it's second down here. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Crossing the 40. Tackle is made, but that's good for a first down of the 47. Another chunk play. This offense is really clicking. The shotgun running play call. And the sophomore able to bring him down quickly. Offense getting set. It's second down. Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. A pop pass on the jet sweep. Takes it inside the 40. Tackle made after a big gain.
I really love the way more and more offenses are using the receiver in motion pre-snap. Give him a chance to get the football with a couple blockers in front of him. He's got all that speed built up. You get the ball in his hands, and you better look out. He could be off to the races.
This Alabama offense is moving quickly down the field.
2-9 Philly.
Quarterback adjusting now to the defense. Back now goes in motion. Defense will have to adjust. Aiming for the end zone. Touchdown, Bama. They jump in front here in the fourth.
Chris, he broke free from the line of scrimmage. I thought he might have a 10 or 15-yard gain, but he shows you the speed that he has to take it all the way to the house.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. PAT is up and good. They lead by a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. Here's the kickoff team. Let's see if they give the returner an opportunity to bring this back. Fielded in the end zone. It's Johnson. And he stopped with the 18. Returner trying to make a play, and a touchback would have been a better idea. And the Arkansas offense is back out on the field now. Handoff from the shotgun. Just a small gain. We're getting second and nine.
Christina, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but what I've been always impressed with defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
To throw, it's Green. But they don't make the connection. That one is incomplete.
Man, Chris, I don't know if that was a bad read by the quarterback or a bad route by the receiver. They got to get this cleaned up before the next time they go through the air.
One of the biggest plays we've had so far. Third down and the crowd really getting into it. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Oh, that one's picked off. Going the other way, can they catch him? Return to pick six. Touchdown, Crimson Tide. And the interception taken to the house. A pick six, potential game-changing play there.
Man, nothing gets a defense, and especially a defensive coordinator, more fired up than a pick six. And let's not forget, give credit to some of those other defenders for making some key blocks to spring that touchdown loose.
Extra point up and good. A two-touchdown lead here now in the fourth quarter. The kickoff team on the field now is set to send this one away. Bringing it out, it's Johnson. Tackled at the 14. Not very good field position to start here. And the Razorbacks offense is back out on the field. It'll be interesting to see if this quarterback can bounce back. He threw a pick six in the last possession. Trying to create outside the pocket now. Aggressive call, a deep shot on first down, but incomplete.
This is smart defense. When you're trying to protect the lead late in the game, you know they're going to take some shots. Get those safeties and those defensive backs back far, anticipating a deep throw, and knock the ball away.
Back to pass. It's Green looking for his big tight end. And he finds a wide open receiver. They forgot about him downfield. Heads out of bounds after a solid gain, more than enough to pick up a first down.
Well, that's everything you could hope for here for an offense. They make a nice completion here. Thing that really stood out to me, your fourth quarter, late in the game, the clock is essential. Get out of bounds when you can. Get a first down when you can. He does both here to set up the offense here nicely.
That's the running back who makes the catch across the middle. They bring him down, but a big chunk of yardage on the play. And the Razorbacks hustle to the line to run the hurry up.
Well, this is the risk you take when you play man-to-man coverage and you leave a linebacker on a running back. Quarterback does a nice job of seeing that mismatch and getting the ball to the back for some good yards.
The Razorbacks begin a new series here, first and 10. There's the snap, looking to throw the ball. And that's just thrown away. I don't think he's going to get away with that. Yeah, here comes the flag. What's the play call here on second down for this offense? Looking to throw again. And the clock winding down, they'll take a deep shot. And the pass is intercepted as he throws into double coverage that time. It's a short return, but a takeaway for this defense.
Well, this defense has been great the entire football game here. They knew they had a lot of pressure on them in the playoffs. They stepped up and played well all game long, and now they get a critical interception here late in this game.
So it's first and 10 inside the 5. How does the coaching staff play this? So they run the ball to get some breathing room, or will they trust the QB and be more aggressive here? And now a timeout taken by the defense, trying to preserve as much clock as possible for their offense. Second down after that run on the previous play. Hand off to the back. They'll keep the clock moving. The junior able to bring him down quickly. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. They come to the line. A long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. Keeping it on the ground here. And he breaks clear down the right side. It's a foot race. He's at the 50. Now the 40. The 20. Past the 10. Touchdown. Tied. Made the defense look slow that time. That's another touchdown for this running back. They can't stop him. Dream performance in this playoff game.
Yeah, this is going to be a performance we're going to be talking about for a long time. I just love watching because he's doing it in so many different ways. We've seen speed. We've seen his physicality. He's breaking tackles. Boy, just an absolute dream scenario, as you said.
Extra point up and good. A 3-touchdown lead now here in the final quarter. Getting set to kick the ball off now. Fielded in the end zone. It's Johnson. Tackled at the 14. Not very good field position to start here. And the Arkansas offense back out on the field. Well, this has been a disappointment. They've had their doors blown off here. He's playing for pride at this point. Fires it to the wideout. He's a wide open receiver, complete. Stop out at the 39, but good enough for a first down. The clock is still running. They got to get set quickly. First down, looking to throw the ball. Quarterback delivers complete to the right side. He's brought down, but not before getting into enemy territory at the plus 47. And the Razorbacks looking to use the up-tempo offense here. Back to throw. It's Green. It's an out route. The catch made. And a big game before he goes out of bounds. The offense keeps churning, gets a fresh set of downs.
Well, this offense has a long way to be able to get back and potentially win this game. But they're doing the right things, managing the clock, picking up good yards, and getting out of bounds.
Looking to throw it on first down. Put quickly. To get him down quickly, not much of a gain on that completion. That completion makes it second and medium. And the quarterback looking to make a play through the air. Heavy pressure, he lets it go. Able to throw it away, he felt the heavy pressure, took a hit, but got rid of the football.
Boy, this offense has really struggled today, Chris, when it comes to throwing the football. They have dug themselves a huge hole. They're not going to have any chance of coming back. And I think one thing about this is...
It's a fumble! Guy who pops it up, recovers it, and prevents the turnover. Now the offense will take a timeout here with 30 seconds remaining.
The offensive staff just took a collective sigh of relief. But I'd still anticipate that someone's going to pull that ball carrier aside, give him a couple choice words on the importance of ball security.
Caught near the goal line. Four set of bounds after a nice gain. The offense is knocking on the door with a first and goal. The Razorbacks line up with a first and goal. There's the snap. They'll set up to throw.
Boy, Chris, I thought when he took off on that scramble, I thought he had a chance to maybe get it to the end zone. But the defense does a nice job. Yeah, they gave up a couple yards, but they kept him out of the end zone.
Quarterback wants to throw it on second down. And it's incomplete. Just 5 seconds left on the clock now.
How about the defense today? They have played so well. I think the defensive coordinator put together a great plan. His kids clearly understood their scheme because they have been aggressive and attacking all game long.
Trying to throw for it on third and goal. Intercepted in the end zone. Not much on the return, but they snuff out the drive with the takeaway.
Oh, you feel terrible for this quarterback. He's played well all year. He's trying to make a play, trying to force it into coverage because they need points at this point in the game to try to advance into the next round of the playoffs. Puts it into coverage, and that's probably going to do it.
And he's brought down, and that should do it for the ballgame. Of course, in the playoffs, it's survive and advance. This is a crucial W, great performance, but now the stage gets even bigger. The challenges will continue going forward.
Yeah, more and more pressure will grow as this team continues to win football games, but you and I have been around this team all year long. So impressed with the emotions and how they're able to contain themselves, stay focused on the task at hand. They did that again today. They advance. Cannot wait to watch and see what they can do next week.
And that is going to wrap it up. We enjoyed this one here. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Chris Fowler, and this has been another present